Hey guys, it's Danny. Welcome back to my channel. For today's video, I'm sharing my crafty stash and my RASKOG setup for all of my December crafting. So that includes happy mail, design team projects, December daily. Anything that I'm using this month will be from these crafty items. I'm also going to be sharing my RASKOG setup as well as part of this, because I do have some stuff on there too. But my goal with sharing the crafty stash and RASKOG is that I really want to try to use up some of the items that I have picked out for December. And I want to do like a crafty empties at the end of the month to show you guys like what I've used up and like how many products I've used and what I struggled using and what I used up really easily, things like that. I have a little bag underneath my crafting desk where I'm gonna throw like all the empty packaging and stuff as I use things up. So hopefully if I'm able to keep up with it at the end of the month, I will be sharing that with you guys as well in case you're interested in seeing just how much of my December stash that I've used up. So enough talking, let me show you what I've got to work with this month. So first is this little container, and you'll notice that I use like little containers to kind of organize things. It's just what works best for me. So in this little clear box, I have some iris containers. These are the photo boxes, the 5x7 ones, and each one has kind of a different color story. So this one is like pinks, blues, silvers, kind of like wintry themed. This one has black and white. This one has all golds and like gold glitter type things in there. And then this one has traditional Christmas colors, so red, green, there's a little bit of silver. There's like gingerbread men in here, hot cocoa things, pine cones, wreaths, all sorts of fun stuff. And then in this little white container compartment thing, I have all of my new die cut packaging. So these are all ones that have been recently purchased that I want to use throughout the month, as well as these letters that I pulled out just so I wouldn't forget to use them. My plan for this is, and you'll see I have a pen in here, is that once I use an element from here, I want to like cross it off or X it out. That way I can keep track of what die cuts belong with what packaging, so that when I go to share at the end of the month, like how much I've used up, we can really easily see, oh, well, I've used, you know, a third of these or half of these or whatever, because hopefully I'll remember to mark things off as I use them. That's kind of the plan with these. So I've got several die cut packs in here. I'm keeping this pen in here so I don't have a reason not to use it. And then here I have some chipboard shapes, some chipboard kind of thickers and phrases. These are some cardstock stickers, more chipboard. This one's already missing one. These are all the L Studio like cut apart label things. So I figured with these it'd be really easy to see at the end of the month like how many I've used up and stuff. Next, these are all of the washies that I pulled out for the month. This little container is actually a desk organizer from the Dollar Tree, and I love these. I have several of these and I use them for different projects. I love all the different size compartments, but anyway, these are all the washies that I pulled out. So I've got some blues and silvers, black and white, some really little ones that like to hide inside of other rolls. These are some metallics, so I've got some golds and like coppery rose gold, some gold glitters, and then these are all of my traditional like Christmas colors, you know? So I've got like the red and whites, the greens, etc. So these are the washies that I'm going to be working with this month. In October, I actually used up a couple of rolls of washi, so I'm curious to see if I'm able to use up any of these, and if so, how many? I think that would be really fun. Next, I have my little embellishment tray thing, and I do have this organized as well. So these are like just random kind of ephemera pieces. So you see I have like a little tassel, paper clips. I have some big stars in here, which I'll talk about in just a second. These are black, white, gold, and silver, and then these are the traditional red and green kind of colorway. These ones are more wintry color. Under here is where I'm keeping all of my like paper stars. So I punched out a bunch of glitter stars already in preparation for the holiday, especially for my December daily. I want stars to be kind of a continuing theme throughout my album. So that's why I went ahead and pre-punched a whole bunch of those. I pulled out some like silver and gold and white ones from my stash. So that's what those are. These ones wouldn't quite fit in there without getting bent. So that's why I'm just keeping them at the top. In this little container thing, I have some kind of larger paper clips. There are some paper clips in here that kind of color coordinate, but I didn't want them to get lost amongst the bigger ones. I have a couple little like matchboxes that I want to use this month. These are like small gold embellishments. Actually, I think Brad's with like big gems on them, but we all know how I feel about Brad. So yeah, these are silver embellishments. So there's like some of these like traveler's notebook things. There's some silver paper clips, some tiny little like bows and stuff. So just some kind of random silver embellishments that are kind of on the bigger side that I don't want to put in here. I also have a little spot for all my wood veneers, and there's a few little cork pieces in here as well. So I've got some tags, some little phrases, a bunch of stars, this pack from El Studio. Again, it's in the packaging. That way at the end of the month, I can say, oh, well, I have used like two of the stars and like one of the circles, and I did use the ho ho ho, so I did good on that. So that's why there's a lot of stuff still in packaging. I don't typically do that. Usually I'm the kind of person, when I craft, I like to take everything out of the packaging and just go for it. So I'm really curious to see how this is going to work this month, me kind of keeping tabs on how much I'm actually using specific products. So I think it'll be kind of an interesting experiment. These are white acrylic words. There's also some shapes in here too. So that's what those are. I have some silver snowflake charms, and then this is the Brad sheet that I showed in my scrapbook.com haul. I also have some roller stamps here. This one is the Christmas one from Simple Stories. I cannot wait to use that. I also have a little chalk ink here, just in case I just wanna grab an ink really quickly, then I have it right there. And then I know this is kind of awkward, but I'm gonna try to do this. So in this big like iris holder box holder thing, it's intended to hold like these cases, like a whole bunch of them, but I take the cases out and just use the box itself sometimes. So in here, I'm keeping all of my stickers. So I know there's a crap ton, you guys. I'm addicted, not even gonna deny it. So in this first little bin or whatever, this first little container, I have a bunch of like random stickers and kind of one-offs and things that I've received in like pocket letters and stuff like that. So these are all just kind of miscellaneous mixed up. In this second container, I have kind of dimensional stickers. So my favorite little glittery ones. Yeah, there's trees. There's also these. There's like, I don't know, puffy stickers, things like that. So I have a bunch of these. So I'm curious to see how many of these I get through. I know for sure I'll get through a bunch of these style because I love them. They're my favorite. And then here in the back section, I have like just some regular shapes, some labels, and these are like flat stickers, ones that don't have any kind of dimension to them. Have some cool scratch off ones. There's like a washi sheet in here for some reason. These ones are a little bit dimensional, but not as much as these. So I just stuck them back here. So I've got a whole bunch of these, some from past years at Target. There's a Mambi sticker book, some little Derice sticker books. And then these tall ones back in the very back are like chipboard stickers. And then again, I know this is super awkward. I'm so sorry. I have this little container here with a bunch of really small little alphas and like little phrase stickers and things. So I have a whole bunch of these. And then here in the back, maybe like this, we can see it. Okay, so in this little like divider thing, I have all of my big alphas and thickers and stuff in here. And then in front of that, I just have like smaller kind of sheets of alphas. So the smaller ones are in the front, the bigger, like thicker type or chipboard alphas are in this little like vial holder thing or whatever. And then behind all my alphas, see, you can see like the back of the file holder thing, I have just a bunch of bags and envelopes. There's like a big tag, there's some vellum envelopes, there's some small red ones, some card bases and envelopes. So like anything that has to do with envelopes or like small bags for Happy Mail are back here. And then like I mentioned, these are my teeny tiny little alphas and some phrases and stuff like that. So I've got a bunch of these. Super fun. I'm definitely a sticker fiend. I think we all know that by now. I also have some leftover black cardstock from October, some plain white cardstock, and then I think I showed these two packs of red and green in my Michaels haul. So I've got these like on the shelving unit, like right next to my workspace. I also have this giant paper pad, and then these three are from my stash. I think I got them last year or the year before. They're really fun, really pretty. That's why I didn't really get a whole lot of 12 by 12 paper for this year, because I knew that I had like plenty to work with. And also on the shelving thing, like Right next to me over here, I have my Kiki K Paper Lovers book. I think this is from a couple of years ago. So I've got that, so I don't forget to use it because I'm always forgetting every holiday to use it. I have these larger sticker sheets that won't fit in my sticker bin, and I don't really want to cut them up because I want to be able to see like how much I've used. So in this first file folder thing, this is an old collection kit from Echo Park. I think it was from last year. I'm pretty sure I did some pocket letters with this and probably shared it here on my channel. So if I can find those, I will link them down below. So I have that all together. That way, if I want to make something using this, everything is right there. These are my newer kind of bought this year papers and like specialty sheets and things. I have showed these in a previous haul. I just wanted to keep them separate from the regular 12 by 12 papers from my stash so that I remember to use them. These are all papers that I've pulled from my stash because again, you guys, I'm trying to like make use of things that I already have. So I did have some like 12 by 12 papers that I pulled out that I thought might work with some projects. I don't know. So I've got some blues, some reds, some greens, all that kind of stuff in this file folder. And then in this last file folder, I have some like specialty sheets like acetate, some vellum. And the theme of this kind of folder or whatever is black and white and like gold. So anything that's like black or white, gray, I think there might be some craft in here. There's like very shiny papers. So I just kind of have it organized by color because that's how I work best, is by color. And then the last thing I have in my little file folder right next to me is this red bag. I showed this in my Dollar Tree haul and I just have the other red bags I've purchased inside of it just to keep it all contained. But I know where they are when and if I need them. So at this point, I'm going to pause the video, kind of readjust, and show you guys my RASKOG. So this is how I have my RASKOG set up. So I did paint mine gold because I wanted it to work for every season and every holiday. And I love gold, so that's what I did. So up here you can see I have some embellishments. These are my enamel dots from my stash that I've pulled out. And then below that are the new ones that I'm working with this year. Did show these in a haul. And then these ones, I got a big old pack from Amazon. I'll try to find it and link it below, but it has like a whole rainbow of colors. I think there's like 2,000 like gemmies or whatever. So I have those in there as well. And then right next to that in this little container are my holiday themed journaling cards. So all the ones from here over are like traditional colors and they're from different manufacturers, which is fine. So I have some from A Beautiful Mess. Like this little card is a cut down from a Kiki K thing. There's Project Life, Becky Higgins, L Studio. There's all sorts in there. And then this next section is all my like wintry colors. So there's pinks and blues and really pretty colors in here, silvers. And then in the back, I have just some plain like journaling type card ones. These ones are double-sided, so you can write them that way or that way, which is cool. And then I also have these like clear acetate 4x6 papers, which would be really fun for overlays. And then this is all my stamping stuff. So I have my favorite inks right here. I also have my favorite punches just so that they're handy. Some stamping blocks, a couple of wooden stamps. I pulled out some of the Christmas colors that I have. I don't have a ton of colored inks, so that's kind of what I'm working with. And then I have a large kind of stamping thing. And then these are all the stamps that I'm working with this month. So I have a bunch of different brands. There's just a bunch in here. I will show you my favorite. I love this penguin. Oh my gosh, I'm obsessed. I also have some dies in here too. So like for example, this set, I put the dies in the back so that I would be able to find it easily if I wanted to use those. And then in the very back, I have some baby wipes and then this big kind of background builder thing. And this IKEA, I don't know, planter, whatever. I keep my fuse tool and I like keeping it in a metal thing. That way I can put it away if it's still warm and not worry about it like melting plastic or whatever. These are a bunch of straws. I recently hauled these two packs and these were in some Happy Mail. I have these tinsel things. I have some smaller paper pads back here as well as some kind of smaller loose papers. So I have this patterned one and then this glitter one by Heidi Swap. These are a little bit used. My glitter one, I'm so sad, is like definitely used. I've used maybe half this pad already and it makes me so sad. It makes me not want to use it, but that's not really the point, right? The point is to use our fun stuff. This is my hot glue gun. along with the glue sticks. This is my little Dymo light clicky label maker thing. And that is my top level of the RASKOG. Oh yeah, there's also these Tim Holtz like rub on things. I don't know how good these are gonna be. We'll see. The ones I used in Halloween were crap by the time I used them, so hopefully these are still good. The second or middle level of my RASKOG, I have all of my sequins and like different kinds of holiday themed sequins and confetti and glitter. Jemmies. These I pulled out from my sequin storage to use possibly, and I'm sorry if this is a little shaky, the video. Back here I have some bigger ones, so I've got like this mix. I've got some actual glitters. This is supposed to be ornament filler, but I'm going to use it for like shaker pockets. My favorite star and heart confetti. You can see I'm like definitely running low on some of these. And then this little container has a couple of bowls for mixing sequins and things. I have my little scoopy thing that I love to use. And then these are all just kind of random bags of sequins that I just pulled from my sequin drawer and just kind of popped in here. Some of these I've gotten in Happy Mail. I think this one came in the Elf Studio thing. So that's everything in there. I have this little baking cup with some paper cakes bows in there just so I don't forget to use them. And then in the back, I have a bunch of this crepe paper. So I've got some red, some white, and there's a black one as well. There's another white one. And then in the very, very back, I have these guys that I showed in a Dollar Tree haul. So I have snowflakes, I think there's stockings and gingerbread men. And then on this side, I have a couple of these cup things again. So these are different kinds of like sequin trims, some elastic in here. There's a little bit of this black and white ribbon that I didn't want it to get lost with my other ribbon. And then in the back, there's this baker's twine. I love baker's twine, so I'm gonna remember to use it. So that's why I put it in the back and I put this one in the front, because I will more than likely forget to use these, but not those. And then in the bottom level of my RASKOG is pretty much everything that I would want to use or reach for to package Happy Mail or gifts or anything like that. So I have this cool box, I have some doilies, there's some like big ornaments from Dollar Tree behind that, these gift card holders, some more ornaments, and like another one of those like white planter things, some fun tinsel, these cupcake liners. I just didn't really know where else to put them, so I just put them right there. I have some crinkles, some of this like garland stuff, some like little lunchboxy things. There are paper bags back here, some plastic bags. So anything that I could possibly want to make a package look pretty is kind of on this bottom level. And then over here I just have some glitter ribbon. So there's a few different colors and things in there. But that is it for today's video. Thank you guys so much for watching my crafty stash and RASKOG tour. I hope that you were able to come up with some ideas for organizing your supplies for this month. Please make sure to subscribe so you don't miss any of my December videos. I'm going to be doing a video every single day this month, so I know you don't want to miss out. And make sure to stick around to the end of the month so you can see how much of this stuff I actually use, because I'm very interested to see how much of this stuff I actually use. So anyway, thank you guys so much for watching, and I'll see you tomorrow. Bye!